The turbojet was first invented in 1928 by Frank Whittle. Heinkel He-178 was the first aircraft to fly under turbojet power. The Gloster E-2839 Gloster Whittle made the first British jet engine flight in 1941. Turbojet engine has several parts. The turbojet can be thought of as a high-tech propeller inside of a duct, called a diffuser driven by gas generator. The core of a jet engine is a gas generator that creates high-pressure gas to power a turbine. This setup has compressor, combustor, and turbine sections. Commercial aircraft tend to use high-bypass turbofan engines, which are suitable only for subsonic flight, flying slower than the speed of sound, or 1225 km per hour. These engines optimize fuel efficiency and reduce noise. In contrast, military fighter jets use low-bypass turbojet engines, which are generally noisier than commercial aircraft engines. Most have afterburners for additional thrust and noise, and can fly faster than the speed of sound, supersonic, or faster than 1,225 km per hour. In certain conditions, this can create a sonic boom. The engines need higher power-to-weight ratios for speed and maneuverability. A turbojet is the simplest kind of jet engine based on a gas turbine. Most modern passenger and military aircraft are powered by gas turbine engines, which are also called jet engines. The first and simplest type of gas turbine is the turbojet. It's a basic rocket jet that moves a plane forward by firing a hot jet of exhaust backward. The exhaust leaving the engine is much faster than the cold air entering it, and that's how a turbojet makes its thrust. Turbojets. The basic idea of the turbojet engine is simple. Air taken in from an opening in the front of the engine, then it is compressed 3 to 12 times its original pressure in compressor. Fuel is added to the air and burned in a combustion chamber to raise the temperature of the fluid mixture to about 1100 Fahrenheit to 1300 Fahrenheit. The resulting hot air is passed through a turbine, which drives the compressor. If the turbine and compressor are efficient, the pressure at the turbine discharge will be nearly twice the atmospheric pressure. And this excess pressure is sent to the nozzle to produce a high-velocity stream of gas, which produces a thrust. Substantial increases in thrust can be obtained by employing an afterburner. It is a second combustion chamber, positioned after the turbine and before the nozzle. The afterburner increases the temperature of the gas ahead of the nozzle. The result of this increase in temperature is an increase of about 40% in thrust at takeoff, and a much larger percentage at high speeds, once the plane is in the air. The turbojet engine is a reaction engine. In a reaction engine, expanding gases push hard against the front of the engine. The turbojet sucks in air and compresses or squeezes it. The gases flow through the turbine and make it spin. These gases bounce back and shoot out of the rear of the exhaust, pushing the plane forward. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.